Radical Firearms AR-15 full-length M-lock rail, mid-length gas system, Mission First Tactical minimalist stock, and also Mission First Tactical engage V2 grip. Oh my goodness, this has got to be like a $1,000 rifle, right?
Try under 700.
Under 700. What can you get for under 1,000? Hey everybody, Clint here with Classic Firearms, coming at you guys today with another top video. This one's going to be a top 5 on the top AR-15s under $1,000. And these are all from my personal experience. Sure, there's a lot of AR and AR-15s, AR manufacturers out there that I haven't had the privilege to go and pull the trigger on, but for a lot of these are ones, again, under $1,000 that I've had personal experience with, personal ownership of, and ones that just work and haven't given me any issues. So I'm happy about that, right? So let's just go ahead and roll right into this thing, guys. We do have a Smith & Wesson M&P Sport 2 on here. This is the M&P 15. And this guy here, when I used to work at the police department as a 911 call taker and dispatcher at a small local town here in North Carolina, a lot of officers had these as their ARs, actually, believe it or not, the M&P 15. And there are two different variations of this rifle. You've got the Sport and Sport 2. The Sport 2 actually has the forward assist, dust cover, and you know, is like a real AR. So cool. These things work. Again, all of these are American made, minus one that we'll talk about here in just a few. And Smith & Wesson has just been around a long time, as we all know, making some affordable yet quality firearms. And anytime somebody's like, hey man, I'm trying to find a good AR for, like, you know, under $1,000, under $800, under $700, like, what do you recommend? And I'm like, man, there are a lot of options out there. Honestly, just go do some homework, you know, just do that quick little Google search and you'll see all sorts of articles out there. So we figured, let's just go ahead and throw this in a video. And typically a Smith & Wesson M&P is actually always on my list because why? They work, they're reliable, and I trust it. It's a good rifle. So there we go. One that's very similar to it, just in looks, this is the Double Star, what they call the Star 15. And this guy here, just like the M&P, has a heavy barrel, has a carbine length gas system on it, A2 front sight post, your standard, you know, carbine, you know, hand guards here that just has the delta ring. You can pop these off, replace them with, you know, M-lock rails, quad rails, whatever you want. You can do that on these. And this one here comes what we call in the industry is optics ready. In other words, it doesn't ship with sights. The M&P, however, does come with a Magpul backup rear, which is nice. The Double Star here does, like I said, come optics ready, but you still get the quality, of course, but you also still get A2 pistol grip, which would be like the first thing that I change out, or just sand that guy down right there, you know, and also to the adjustable stock on this. And this guy up here is actually a little bit more expensive than the M&P, and I can kind of see why. I talked with Double Star at the SHOT Show this previous year, keeping our fingers crossed that it's still on for 2021, but I talked with their blade section and I reviewed some of their firearms there, just taking a look and then talking with the guys about their products. And guys, these guys pride themselves on what they manufacture and make, and their blades that they have too are really cool things. So if you're interested in an awesome breaching tool and maybe just some good knives, go check out Double Star for that. But they also have their firearms lineup, which again, just great quality stuff. So I definitely appreciate those guys, and they also pride themselves on their customer service. So check out Double Star if you are in the market. All right, next one we're going to talk about here, we're getting into some M-lock rails, as you can tell, since the other ones don't have any attachment type system. Well, I can't say any. There are ways to attach things on here if you got duct tape, right? No, there are ways to attach things to your standard M4 handguards, but M-lock rail systems are great. Why? Because they're slim, they're lightweight, and they just work. They got a nice slim profile to them, and I'm always happy with an M-lock rail, you know, but you guys know me, I do love my quad rails too, so I like to torture myself with weight, I guess. But anyway, this guy right here is Diamondback. So the Diamondback DB15s are a great lineup as well. I've had plenty of their firearms. My first AR pistol was a Diamondback, and then I later on changed the barrel out to be a 300 blackout, and the thing always shot great, and never gave me any issues whatsoever. So Diamondback, with my personal experience, this was before the logo change and everything else, was great. And having the ones that I've shot recently, yeah, these things just work. Now what's cool about this guy too is the fact that it's not only coming with the M-Lock rail here, nice slim rail, you've got your Picatinny right up front for a front sight if you want it, and then it's nice and smooth right here, which allows for that great C-clamp grip, as a lot of people have, that thumb over bore. That's more comfortable for me. So like that right there. And then of course you can have whatever type of optic set up here, but it's also coming with a P-Mag and also Magpul grip. I also am a big fan of their MOE grips and their K2s that they have out there. But yeah, great brand. Again, Diamondback, USA. Again, most of these are. This one here, it does have a carbine system length on it as well. And then we've got the Springfield St. Victor, which has a mid-length gas system on it. And this one, this is the most expensive one that we're featuring, coming in at just under $1,000. This one does feature the BCM furniture. They have the same model coming with my beloved B5 Systems type furniture, but that one puts it just a hair over $1,000, so couldn't really feature that. So the BCM ones here are still very great items. It's a great grip angle, and also a great stock. So definitely recommend. But the Springfield Saint also coming with an enhanced flat face trigger on it. Very nice. I think Springfield just did a really good job with the Saint. When they announced that they were gonna start making ARs, a lot of people along with myself were like, great. Another manufacturer making ARs, because that's not a saturated market, right? However, now we're finding we need more manufacturers making ARs. Crazy times to be alive, right? But when they came in with it, they actually started making really cool guns with a lot of, you know, high-end furniture and accessories, and still keeping at a very reasonable price point, in my mind at least. So I'm real happy that they've gotten into the game and have actually made some great ARs. And we've talked with them at the NRA show last year. We've also talked with them at SHOT Show this previous year, and you know, they're just always great guys, and they're always willing for us to, hey, go shoot some stuff, you know. It's like, okay, yeah, sure, why not. But the St. Victor that you see here comes with a full length M-Lock rail on it, so it allows you to put accessories and attachments all over the place, similar to the Diamondback too. It does have just a non-cuts here, I guess, but the Diamondback does have M-Lock on top, so if you wanted to add any more attachments up here, you can. All right. But the Springfield Saint also comes with a two-chamber brake on it. Brakes also, you know, help with recoil, keeping it a nice flat shooter. And they also come with Springfield's backup iron sight setup. And these things are actually pretty sweet. They are easy to manipulate, easy to activate, and work great. They offer a great sight picture as well, and I'm happy that they do include sights too, so it's pretty nice. Also ships with a P-Mag as well, so very cool stuff. All right. Next one too that I can talk about is, if you are looking, if you do like the Springfield Saint, they offer it in all sorts of different variants. Got another one over here. This is your mid-length system as well, but this is pretty much the same gun, just not as high speed, right? So this guy here does have your M-Lock rail on it, but this is just a polymer rail, not free floated like on this guy. And it comes with your standard bird cage, still has the BCM furniture on it, still comes with the Springfield Armory rear backup iron sight. Does not come with the flat facing trigger, just a polished mil-spec. But yeah, this guy is really nice, and I actually like it, you know, for what it is. This is a really nice setup. And again, coming in at under $1,000, I would definitely seriously consider the Springfield Saint lineup for sure. All right, so that's what we've got on the table, but we've also got a few that aren't on the table right now. And the other one I want to talk about is the IWI Zion, our only not made in the USA rifle, but coming in from Israel. And it's not like IWI has any experience in manufacturing firearms at all. Right, yeah, these guys have a renowned reputation. They've been around for a long time, and they've been needed for a long time. As you guys know, Israel is always in some sort of conflict, and they need to make sure that they have a firearms manufacturer that can produce the type of quality firearms they need to make sure they're staying in the fight. And the IWI Zion is no exception. That thing is just a sweet all-around AR. Guys, that one's also coming with the B5 stock on it, which, again, I love that SOP mod stock. It's just really awesome. And for them to throw that on there, and also, too, just putting their quality and, again, their reputation behind that AR, I definitely recommend that to just about anybody. Again, shopping for an AR under $1,000. I'd recommend all of these. You really just kind of have to do that Google search on all of them, see which ones you like more so than others, see what little things that you might prefer over others. And then it really comes down to, you know, your fanboys too. It's like, oh man, if we had an HK sitting over here, it doesn't matter what it was, it'd probably be the best AR-15, even though it's an MP5. Somebody would say it's better, you know, who knows. But you just gotta really do your own research and see what's out there. I'm just telling you guys my personal thoughts. IWI Zion, real sweet one. And then we got two others in a honorable mention here. We've got the SIG M400 Tread and the Ruger AR-556. Again, both rifles are awesome. We all know SIG, and for them to come out with an affordable firearm is awesome. But for them to come out with an affordable firearm that's also still reliable and has that name behind it, very happy to offer the M400 Tread. And my experience with it has just been with like any other SIG firearm that I've personally owned or shot, it's been awesome. So there you go. And the Ruger AR-556, another brand that has been around for decades and decades and decades, and they just keep on producing high quality firearms. And I would definitely recommend a Ruger as well. Never had any issues with those. So yeah, guys, let me know down in the comments, what's your pick? It doesn't have to necessarily be any of these, of course, but if you are recommending an AR-15 for under $1,000 to one of your friends that's getting into the market or getting into the AR game, what would you recommend? I'm curious to hear from you guys. All right. Last thing I want to remind you guys is to go ahead, head on over to classicfirearms.com, hit that top banner and get your entries in, your daily entries if you haven't done it yet, for the Fulton Armory M14. This is the enhanced service rifle that we've got built up as the DMR that you guys saw in the movie Black Hawk Down. It doesn't have the cool, you know, sand paint job on it, but they have this set up to imitate Sergeant First Class Randy Shughart's M14, the Medal of Honor recipient, the same rifle that he used the day that he received the Medal of Honor, the day that he took the actions to receive the Medal of Honor. Big shout out to Aimpoint, who provided the optic for this. These are just a great brand as well that's also seen service all over the world, including in the United States military. So very cool that Aimpoint hopped on the ball and they're like, oh yeah, you're giving away one of these guys, and for what it's worth or for what it represents, yeah, we can totally give you an optic. So again, big shout out to Aimpoint for providing the optic. Guys, head on over to classicfirearms.com, hit that top banner to get your entries in for the Fulton Armory M14 Black Hawk Down commemorative rifle. All right. And again, I'll see you guys down in the comments about your favorite ARs under $1,000. God bless you all, and we'll see you next time at classicfirearms.com.